Shining Giants. Welcome back to BDTV. I'm Samara McNary.
Oh, and I'm Luke Smith. What's up?
Dude, we're literally filming right now. You're still on your phone? What's your deal?
I don't know. I just didn't want to put it down. It's not a big deal.
Do you know what I'll call that?
What?
Addiction. Now let's go to Bailey to see if she can shed some light on this topic.
Prior to 2018, K, our proportionality constant, was defined to have a precise value in terms of the speed of light in a vacuum, C, class, guys.
Phone usage is something we see a lot nowadays, especially from teenagers. It seems normal to see people on their phones in class 24/7, but is it really though? Studies found that 78% of teens feel addicted to their devices, while 59% of parents believe that kids are also addicted to their devices. Phone addiction can cause negative effects on school, cause insomnia, increase anxiety, depression, and so much more. It's good to set a screen time for your phone and be able to set your phone down to pay attention in school and to enjoy quality time with the people you love. So next time you find yourself deep in your phone, consider setting it down and taking a break. Bailey Spencer, BDTV.
Labor Day is celebrated every first Monday of September. But why do we celebrate it? Labor Day is a day to honor people's hard work around the country by giving them a day of rest. Today, we celebrate Labor Day with parades, barbecues, and a day off school. But it's important to remember that there are still countries around the world that don't give their workers as many freedoms. We should honor those who fought and made sacrifices to give us the rights we have today. Make sure to make the most out of this day and acknowledge those who can't have a single day of rest. Stephanie Lopez, BDTV.
Thanks, Stephanie, for telling us more about Labor Day. Now let's see what Jeffrey can tell us as we check back in with Spotlight.
Are you tired of endlessly scrolling, waking up in every moment of your life revolving around a 4x2 rectangle of LED diodes, checking your feed at every possible second that you could, refreshing and refreshing to see if that message has been responded to yet? It's time to read something real. The Ben Davis Spotlight's print issue, themed around school safety, will be released next Friday, September the 9th.
Cooking is a skill everyone needs to learn about in life. Here are the chefs that will talk about it.
Well, first off, it's culinary arts.
We cook a lot of different foods. We learn all the basic different techniques, French, international, different cooking methods, learn about food safety.
So we go through everything you're going to need to be successful when you enter the culinary arts field, from, like I said, food safety all the way through till behind the scenes management aspects, human resources, menu development, that type of stuff.
Corbin Harris, BDTV.
Whoa, what you doing? You got COVID or something?
Yeah.
Rule number one to keeping you and others clean is to stay socially distanced.
Rule number two, you always want to wash your hands.
Use a mask to cover coughs and sneezes.
Lastly, rule number four, clean up area when leaving. If you do have COVID, the best thing to do is drinking water and staying hydrated.
Getting plenty of rest to help the body fight the virus.
What's up, you seen?
What up? What you figured it to?
I'm finna go to class. You coming?
Nah, I finna go to smoke. You trying to come with me?
Nah, I'm good. I think you should come to class.
Nah, I'll try to smoke.
I guess.
I ain't good.
I heard everything. You're coming with me.
Drugs ruin your education. Say no to drugs.
So, does talking about food make anybody else hungry? Man, I should definitely grab some food after... Oh, wait. I'm broke. Well, if you're like me and you want to go to college and eat, you may want to apply for FAFSA. Let's see if Aiden can teach us more about it.
Whether you are a senior or a sophomore, you can never start thinking about college too soon. You may be asking yourself, how do I get started, or why should I get started so soon? Well, I'm going to answer those two questions for you. How do you get started? Easiest way to get started is find a career path, and if Area 31 has that career, then join Area 31. That is one of the best options out there. You are getting experience in the real world, but during school time. Other ways you can start is figure out what college you want to attend and what colleges have the right major for you and your career path, and maybe even visit a college when you have free time. After you have found your college and you know what to do, you need to start applying for colleges. College applications have deadlines, and it is important to make sure you meet those deadlines. Now the other question, why should you start now? You don't want to wait till you're a senior because that will make your senior year very stressful. Some colleges have a very short deadline. Also, you want to apply for financial aid and scholarships if you can, because they will lower your tuition and make cost of college easier on yours and your parents' wallet. Aiden Lindell, BDTV.
Last Saturday at the Ruoff Music Center during the Logic and Wiz Khalifa performance, chaos erupted as 23,000 people were evacuated from the venue. Many were hurt due to tight spaces. With many more concerts coming up, here are a few tips to stay safe and have fun. According to CNN, avoid mosh pits. They may look fun, but it's really easy to get injured in one. If you do find yourself in one, protect your head with your hands. Wear tennis shoes so you can easily navigate through crowds. And remember, have fun and enjoy the show, as long as it is in a safe way. David Lusk, BDTV.
Destiny.
Oh. I'm Destiny Dunnigan, and this is Destiny on the Street. Should cereal be considered a soup?
I missed it.
Should cereal be considered a soup?
No.
Why not?
Never had crunchy soup.
You haven't?
No.
Why are you late? I didn't make you late.
You didn't.
So why are you late?
I was on my way.
What class were you coming from?
Coming from?
Yeah.
Pre-calc.
What hall?
Double A.
So upstairs?
Yeah.
And you're going to choir, right?
Yeah.
So why were you late?
I don't know.
They're right there.
It is.
Why were you late?
Because of her.
Perfect example of what not to do, guys.
Next person to ask. Can we ask you a question? What'd you say?
I have a question.
Oh, okay.
Do you drink milk every day?
Not every day.
Is that?
Is that why you're kind of short?
I'm the tallest in this circle.
You sure?
I mean,
or is your perception of reality just messed up right now?
What are you talking about?
Are you sure?
I'm positive.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Are you?
Yeah.
From right here, you look shorter than me. Are you sure your depth perception isn't just wrong or height perception? Hello.
Yeah.
What's your name?
Donovan.
Donovan what?
Medina Miller.
Aren't you on BDTV? You look a little familiar.
Yes, I am.
Okay, let's ask you a question anyways. What's your least favorite thing about life?
The people.
The people?
Yes.
Why?
Certain people.
Why?
Annoying.
Aren't you just beefy?
Huh?
No. That's your problem.
Sure. I'm just playing
on that. Destiny Adenikin, BDTV.
What's going on, Wayne Township? Today we have a high of 90 with a low of 60. And there's no rain for this week, so make sure to leave your umbrellas at home. For all my athletes, make sure to drink as much water as possible. And for all my partiers this weekend, you know, make sure to wear your sunscreen. Kay Thompson, BDTV.
Well, it's a good thing we're getting good weather to kick off, huh? Speaking of sports, let's see what Clay has for us this week with our Giants sports teams.
The Giants traveled to Avon last Friday to play the Orioles. The Giants played a great defensive game with the help of the junior, Nyland Brown, who led the team with 15 tackles. The junior, Tommy G, made his debut against the Orioles last Friday. He threw for 223 yards on 15 out of 20 attempts against Avon. Sophomore Elijah Price ran for 143 yards with 3 touchdowns. Tonight at 7 p.m., the Giants travel to Pike High School to play the Red Devils. Next, we have our girls volleyball team. Our girls volleyball team played a tough 3 sets against Speedway and Lawrence North High School this past week. Our girls volleyball team will travel to Franklin Central High School to play the Flashers next week, Tuesday at 7:30 p.m. Our boys soccer team play the Quakers tomorrow at home at 11:30 a.m. Our girls soccer team played a tough game against Lawrence North this past week. Join us to help support our girls volleyball team as they take on the Flashers at home at 6 p.m. This past weekend, our cross-country team placed 11th out of 17 teams in the Brownsburg Invitational. Tomorrow, our cross-country team will travel to Brownsburg to compete against the Bulldogs at 8:30 a.m.
506.
Our boys tennis played Covenant Christian this past week, winning the game with a final score of 3-2. Our boys tennis play the Quakers at home at 5 p.m. next week, Tuesday.
What's up, upperclassmen?
Many of you are turning 18 soon.
And that means you guys need to get out there and register to vote.
Yes, y'all need to vote.
All you need to do is go on USA.gov and click on the Register to Vote tab.
It's just that simple.
Just click on the tab and fill out the information in less than 10 minutes.
This is how your voice will be heard.
Yes, whether you're a Democrat
or a Republican
or both.
Just remember that we are all in this together.
As Americans.
Prez Ajayi.
Damari Edwards.
Dorian Hamilton.
BDTV.
Here are some ways to help prevent yourself from texting and driving.
First off, be sure to put your phone face down and on Do Not Disturb.
If you need to answer your phone, pull over on the side of the road or park somewhere before doing so. Even if you're sitting at a red light, don't get on your phone to text.
One message can cause an accident, so remember to be careful and drive responsibly.
Hi, I'm Chloe Belton. I'm a varsity cheerleader here at Ben Davis High School.
And I'm Jeffrey Dreyer. I'm a tennis player here at Ben Davis.
And today, we're switching
sports.
Touch. Ooh, the stretch. The stretch.
Now, we're doing a toe touch.
I hurt.
Moving on to Herky. Now let's see if Jeffrey can do a round off.
That was good.
All right, so first up, we're gonna do some volleys.
Oh my God.
You ready, Chloe?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Next up, we're gonna see if Chloe can return some serves.
Go, Chloe.
All right, now let's see if she can actually serve the ball.
Big stuff, Chloe.
So that was it for our Switcheroo Giants. Me personally, I could see myself having a future in tennis.
I'm not gonna do cheerleading. I'm gonna stick to tennis. But who do you think did it best?
I'm Chloe Belton.
And I'm Jeffrey Dreyer.
BDTV.
I'm Taryn Cole. And I'm Destiny Dedekin, and we are your class of 2023 Purple Rain leaders.
And this is Student Section Etiquette.
Woo! Rule one, seniors in the front. If you're not a senior or a Purple Rain leader, you stay behind the fence. We already have too much commotion trying to figure out who belongs in the front.
Rule number two, if you're wearing the theme, sit with the crowd. We need as much participation as possible. Your attire is your invitation to the party, so turn up. Lastly, have fun. We need as much participation as possible.
And we need your help this year, Giants, because we want to win the Operation Football Trophy and the Indy Star banner.
And it takes all of your guys' school spirit to make this happen.
And we hope to see you at Pike this week.
Taryn Cole,
Destiny Dunnikin,
BDTV.
What's up, guys? I'm Drew Schreier, and welcome to the Trivia Challenge. Today, we're going to be asking each other questions, and if you get it right, you get to slap the other person with the tortilla. You get it wrong, you get slapped, and it actually hurts a lot more than you guys would think. Let's get right into it.
What is the only food that cannot go bad?
Probably honey.
Honey is correct.
Oh no!
Oh
my gosh!
What is the most visited tourist attraction in the world?
Eiffel Tower.
That's correct.
I didn't even get the answer choices! Oh my gosh.
How many infinity stones are there?
Six.
Dude, these are, I can't wait for these to be thrown. I can't wait for these.
All right, Drew, what is the heaviest organ in the human body?
Liver.
It is the liver.
Yes, sir!
Well, I definitely won that. If you guys want to see more from us, go ahead and check out our social medias. Also, if you guys want to leave any suggestions, that would be a great place to do it too. I'm Drew Schreier, BDTV.
Okay, well that concludes our newscast, Giants.
And remember, have a safe and fun three-day weekend.
And remember, if it's about you and me, it's on BDTV.
Hold up, wait, don't stop, keep going, stay.